So you can, I think, quite easily look at the strategy behind that. So we are trying to find, or to give you the possibility to discover passwords, and then to find them somewhere, being open access or being legal full text, okay? Another good news is that we will be relaunching ISI shortly, exactly this month, basically, and ISI was the former name of our company, Institute for Scientific Information. And this is really an advertising. We'll be launched shortly, nearby here, let's see, in our venue, where we'll be hosting our research evaluation seminar. And in this seminar, we'll be present Jonathan Howland, so that is the new boss, the new director of ISI, this new company. So said, let's talk about the discoverability of open access, so the partnership with InfoStory, okay? And first of all, let me stress once again the fact that we are not a publisher, so we are basically neutral, agnostic respect to that, this, and we are also quite neutral respect to the publisher policies. So I will talk it about open access, not open science, very much lower open access, but we are not in principle in favor of open access, we are not doing anything else that making discoverable the open access, okay? We do not prefer open access respect to the rest. That was the situation, well, more or less, when we started to look into open access 3 years ago, or more than 3 years ago in 2014, we just started to flag the open access papers, papers that were coming from open access journals, so journals that were basically indexed in the directory of open access journals. And the result was that we were able to find out from Web of Science core collection, I will always looking at Web of Science core collection today, 2.2 million records. But at the end of last year, we basically started to see the seeds, to see the fruits of the partnership with InfoStory. I don't think that I have to, you know, go deeper in InfoStory. InfoStory is another company founded by two well-known people who are in pre, and basically well-known for Unpaywall. That is the name of the application that they have designed and delivered through Google Chrome and through Firefox. And we have basically funded them to integrate these applications, their services, our Web of Science Core Collection platform. Not only Core Collection, Web of Science platform. And what's happened is that starting the end of next year, now you can retrieve almost 10 million of open access papers in Web of Science Core Collection. And for who hasn't seen it, it's a pity, by the way, it's a box that is not like this. This is just a purple color, but it's a box that you can find out on the left in Web of Science Core Collection and filter for the different type of open access that we have here retrieved. Indeed, we didn't go further in differentiating the type of open access, so we were not interested in unpaywall kind of retrieve is that, by the way, to the license, for instance. We just divided the open access papers in two type of papers, the gold one, that are the gold one because coming from the gold open access journals, but also because coming from hybrid journals, so journals that can accept eventually some papers that could be open, or even journals that have expired their embargo periods. So everything of this is just gold through Unpaywall in Web of Science Core Collection, and the rest, when we look at the repositories and the fact that papers can be retrieved on the repository, are green, published and accepted, and we do not collect the data respect to the submitted one, so when the final version is not, when the version of the paper is not finalized. And by the way, behind all of this, there are the hierarchies, the priorities. So when a paper is both available in a journal and a repository, we put it as a gold and so on and so forth. Obviously, when it's published, it's better than accepted, and so on and so forth, once again. Again, let's stress the point that we do not select differently open access content. So any journal now, since more than 1 year, it's analyzed in this way, their characteristics, the characteristics of the journals is matched against ESCI, it is our new index, Emerging Source Citation Index, and after that, if we could match this criteria for ESCI, start to be indexed on ESCI, and after ESCI can then raise to the upper, all the three standard indexes, the historical indexes, science, social science, arts, humanities. This is true for any type of journals, with no respect to the policies. Open access some overall numbers of the open access. And I started to analyze, you know, the different index. These are the data for, you know, all the papers that you can retrieve on the Science Core collection from 2004. And I started from 2004 just in honor of Messina, that I see right there, because 2004 is the year of the Declaration of Messina. That is the Italian acceptance, if you want, of the Declaration of Dublino, criteria and principle. And you see that you know, there is a growing trend on open access overall in Web of Science Core collection, and now we could say that we are around one quarter of the papers that are open access in the last years, in the last recent. And you see also that 2017 is a bit declining. This is something that is well known, at least there are several papers with respect to that, because open access has a sort of time lag to be retrieved, to be discovered, if you want. So the last year is always a bit later, if you want. This is the situation for the three standard, WAS Classic, WAS 3, you can call them as you want, the three standard historical indexes. It's more or less the same trend. And it's completely different the situation with respect to conference proceedings, that is definitely lagging behind. And unfortunately for Paul and for the books, even more for the books. Okay, so the books, the chapters and books in general are very much less open than the rest in World Science Core collection, obviously. But what was much more surprising is the percentage of SP, the new index that we have started to index. You see that SP comes to heights like 40, 47, and something like this. This is surprising, but maybe not so much, because in SP there are emerging journals. So journals that are not the historical top journals, and obviously open access is probably you know, the best choice for new journals. There are European journals as well, but it's very much focused on, this is cannot be seen, on social science. And this is more surprising, because SP, 50% of the content of SP is social science. And indeed, if you look at the social science with respect to the other index, social science, it's lagging behind the science. Science is purple, social science is green right here. But you see that indeed, in the last year, it is growing. So social science journals are coming to be much more open than they were before, or papers in the social science journals. But let's have a look at Italy. So the overall number with respect to Italy is 23.51. That is more or less aligned with the top countries. UK is just a bit higher. You see, Germany, the best country in Europe is the Netherlands with almost 30%, not discounting Serbia. And percentage of top countries in Europe, countries with more than 100,000 papers, is more or less aligned with some peaks for Netherlands, and unfortunately for Tiberius, the worst one is Romania. And you see that the average is more, Italy is more or less aligned with the average. And this is the situation of Italy. The trend, so overall Italy from 2004 is growing, and now it stands around 27% in the last years. This is the percentage of open access papers that you can retrieve for Italy in World of Science Core collection. And if you look at the breakdown, we can match which are the gold journals, obviously, in the World of Science Core collection. It's not so difficult, so you can retrieve all the journals. And provided what I said before, that the gold is everything related to the journals, basically, for us. There is 8% of the content in Web of Science Core collection that is coming from gold open access journals, so journals in DLRJ. And all the rest of what we meant for gold, I remember that there are the priorities behind, it's basically hybrid. And 3/4 of Web of Science Core collection, with respect to the Italian papers, obviously, it's not open. Exactly aligned with what was saying before with respect to the document types for articles. So if you look at all the articles, so if you look at all the open access articles, all the Italian articles, and all the open access articles, the percentage of papers in the open access in the open access bucket, it's 9% more, whilst it's basically the opposite for what concerns the conference papers. And these are the top categories. You know that in Web of Science Core collection there are 252 categories, different categories. So in absolute terms of papers, always in the time period of 15 years, 2004, 2018, astronomy and astrophysics is the vector categories, but if you look at the relative number, so if you obviously do the ratio between the sides, between the number of open access papers and the sides, you see that apart multidisciplinary, that is really apart, all the top journals, all that, there is microbiology that is over the 50% of the papers can be retrieved that has open access in World of Science for a collection. Obviously, this data could also be available for some analysis in terms of, for instance, library subscription, and so on and so forth. But all of these areas are around 50%, so one of two papers are basically open access. You know also that we are changing here the time frame because we started to collect, index the funding acknowledgements in World Science Core Collection since 2008. Funding acknowledgements are the acknowledgements that are supposed to be on the paper to recognize the importance of funding coming from some funding agencies. And if you collect the data with respect to all the papers that I just mentioned before, the open access papers, obviously Italian open access papers, we have that almost one-third of the papers has been funded by European Union, whatever it is, the type of commissions or directorate of European Union. And then you have all the other data, you see national NIH, Ministry of, before Ministry of Education in Italy, and then Telecom, IRF, and so on. But let's have a look at the impact. It's really true